Hello, everybody. Welcome to the second half. I'm very excited to share this half with you. It's going to be a lot of fun. Just a quick note to performers for afterwards. If we could all have you come up here for a couple of group pictures, that would be lovely. And yeah, I think we'll begin with Karina.
All right. Hello, everybody. My name is Maxwell Kay, and I'm the composer of this next piece that Karina is going to play, which is called Bucolic Fantasy. And I first wrote this back in the spring of 2020 during the catastrophe that was going on at the time. And actually, I just recently gotten accepted to the Young Artist Summer Program at the Curtis Institute of Music, and it had they decided to move online that summer for obvious reasons, and they asked us all to write solo pieces so the faculty could perform them from their homes. And so I got assigned to write for flute, so I wrote this piece, which was performed on a YouTube live stream by the amazing flutist Mimi Stillman. And tonight is actually the in-person premiere, so I'm really happy that Karina decided to, or agreed to play this. I asked her, actually.
Like a week ago.
No. At least 2 weeks. But she actually had a flute recital earlier today, which I didn't know when I asked her. So especially grateful to her for agreeing to play this piece, considering all of that. So this piece, I think the title suggests a lot about it. It sort of is trying to evoke imagery of nature and finding peace in it. And I thought a lot about the flute's historical association with nature, including in Greek mythology, the god Pan was said to carry pan pipes, hence their name. And I also thought about kind of the human activities that have been contributing to the destruction of nature, and so there's a bit of melancholy in there as well. But I hope you find peace from it, especially if you are stressed out, like a lot of people are right now during finals. And I hope you enjoy Bucolic Fantasy.
Thank you. Thank you.
promise the dramatic pause before the quintet is very worth it. It's a very exciting piece, so just sit tight.
After I was done with all my graduate admissions, and I finally had the time to do something I love, but I hadn't had the time to do, which is arranging. So I arranged this piece for my favorite anime. The anime is called Vivi, Fluoride Eyes Song. And the story was set in a fictional modern city, and one day, all of a sudden, without any signs, and all the AIs in the city just decided to wipe out the human race. And the scientist, before he was murdered by an AI robot, he decided to send the only AI that is not controlled by the rest of the AI, which is our protagonist, Vivi. And she was an AI musician, the first AI musician, and she was given a very special and unique task that was to bring happiness to people with her voice. And that is a very obscure task for an AI, because AI was usually given a very specific task, like making machines or something else, very specific. But what does it mean to, you know, bring happiness to people with your music? I just find this very relatable as us musicians, and we always have to compensate between our duty as a musician and duty as a human being, as a family, as a friend, and other things. And the other things that we care, how do we make inspirations? How do we connect? How do we compensate between different important things? So I hope you enjoy. This is Sing My Pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you so much, everyone. How fun was that? That was so cool. One more round of applause, please, for all of our performers. It's really been a very exciting semester of concerts. Those of you who have known of Open Note for a while know that we just got started in kind of December, January. The ideas came to fruition, and it's really took off since then. It's been a really incredible semester. We have an excellent student board, a lot of wonderful people there to help us out, a lot of artistic advisors within the Manus faculty. So many people that have been an inspiration to us within the school and within the community. And of course, all of you are loyal supporters. You make me very proud. Yay. couple other special things, special people to mention. I just want to thank James, James behind the scene running the live stream and the lights, and of course, Clavier House. We want to thank Clavier House for generously providing this beautiful space and this gorgeous concert piano to us students for these much needed performance opportunities. So thank you, Clavier House. Clavier House, they are experts in the restoration and sales of Hamburg and New York Steinway pianos, and you can definitely hear for yourself the hard work that they put into all of these instruments. If you are in the piano buying market, if you would like, please take some business cards by the front door. Feel free to try out all the incredible pianos around the room, and definitely spread the word about their services. Clavier House also hosts a lot of different concerts here, so if you're looking for more live music, here is your spot. In terms of other Open Note events, we have one final concert at the Old Stone House in Brooklyn this Wednesday at 7 p.m. I encourage you all to come. It's going to be great. It's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of cool people are playing, so that will be very cool. Open Note this spring is also hosting a spring solo recital festival with 23 students performing solo recitals here at Clavier House. So I encourage you to check out. We have a new website. It'll also be in Clavier House's website, I think. Anyways, lots of cool people playing, so check that out. Come find some people to support. And yeah, thank you so much, everyone. It's been so fun. Oh, also, if we could have performers jump up here for a group picture, that would be great. Thank you.